Let's start exploring intersections with the following. Given two lines in two dimensions, where do they intersect? First, let's make a definition. Two lines are parallel if their normal vectors are parallel. So, for example, these lines are parallel because their normal vectors differ by a factor of -2, whereas these two lines are not parallel because their normal vectors are not parallel. It may seem strange that we are using normal vectors in our definition instead of direction vectors. In two dimensions, the definitions are equivalent. However, in higher dimensions, there will not be a single direction vector, so using the normal vector will be more extensible later on. If two lines are not parallel, then they will have an intersection at a single point. However, if two lines are parallel, then there are two possibilities. They might not intersect at all, or they might turn out to be the same line, so-called coincident lines, in which case they will intersect in infinitely many points. In linear algebra, this trichotomy of cases for intersections is the rule. When asked whether two linear objects intersect, the answer is that there will either be a unique point of intersection, there will be no common intersection, or there will be infinitely many intersection points. There cannot just be two or three intersections. So, given two lines in two dimensions, how can we tell whether they have an intersection? Well, first we should check whether they are parallel by looking at their normal vectors. If their normal vectors are parallel, then we need to check whether they are the same line. How can we do this? Suppose the two lines are coincident, that is, the same line. Then, if I take any point from the first line and any point from the second line, in reality from the same line, then the vector connecting the two points will be parallel to both lines. In other words, this vector will be orthogonal to both lines' normal vectors. On the other hand, suppose the two lines are not coincident, but still parallel. Then these lines have no common intersections. So if we pick a point from the first line and a point from the second line, then the vector connecting the two points won't be in the direction of the lines. In other words, this connecting vector won't be orthogonal to either of the normal vectors. This gives us a computable test for whether two lines are the same once we know that they're parallel. Two parallel lines are coincident or equal if and only if the vector connecting some pair of points, one from each line, is orthogonal to both the line's normal vectors. Okay, now let's suppose we have two non-parallel lines, so we know they will intersect. How do we find their intersection point? Let's write the lines in their standard forms, ax plus by equals k1, and cx plus dy equals k2. I write this left curly brace to indicate that this is a system of simultaneous linear equations. So how do we go about solving this system? It would be nice to divide the first equation through by a so that we can solve for x. However, what if a equals 0? Well, if that were the case, we could move to the other equation and then try dividing this second equation through by c. But what if c is also 0? Actually, that can't happen, because if a and c are both 0, then the lines are just of the form y equals k1 over b and y equals k2 over d, which are both horizontal lines. But since we assume the two lines were not parallel, they both can't be horizontal. So that means either a or c has to be non-zero. To make matters simpler, let's just do the following at the beginning of the whole procedure. We check to make sure a does not equal 0. If so, then we swap the order of the two equations. So a and c would swap places, b and d swap places, and k1 and k2 also swap. Then we can always assume that a does not equal 0. So with that assumption that a is not 0, we can go ahead and divide through by a, giving us x plus b over a y equals k1 over a. Now, instead of solving for x directly, I'm going to do something slightly different. I will now subtract c times the left-hand side of this equation from the second equation. To maintain the balance of the second equation, I'll also subtract c times k1 over a from the right-hand side of the second equation. So now our second equation looks like cx plus dy minus cx minus bc over ay equals negative c k1 over a plus k2. The C terms cancel, and after collecting the Y terms together, we get quantity D minus BC over A times Y equals negative CK1 over A plus K2. Now let's multiply through by A to make the equation a bit nicer to work with. And then, to solve for Y, we can divide through by AD minus BC. Or can we? What if AD minus BC equals zero? Well, if this is the case, then let's rewrite the left-hand side as a dot product using the trick we used before. This gives us the vector AB dotted with the vector D minus C equals zero. Now, this first vector is a normal vector to the first line, and the second vector, D minus C, is parallel to the second line. Looking at this geometrically, this means that the line AX plus BY equals K1 is parallel to the line in the direction of D minus C, which is CX plus DY equals K2. But this violates our initial assumption that the lines were not parallel. So, AD minus BC cannot equal zero under this assumption. Great! So that means we can divide through by AD minus BC. So Y equals negative CK1 plus AK2 over the quantity AD minus BC. Now let's use the same subtraction process to go from this equation back to our first equation. If we subtract B over A times Y from the left-hand side, then we can subtract B over A times all of this from the right-hand side. This gives us the messy-looking equation. X equals K1 over A minus B over A times quantity minus CK1 plus AK2 over quantity AD minus BC. Let's pull out a factor of 1 over A to make it a bit cleaner, and then forming a common denominator for the K1 term allows us to consolidate the fraction inside the parentheses. This lets us kill the BCK1 terms, and then cancel the factors of A to get this final form, x equals dk1 minus bk2 all over ad minus bc. So the point of intersection of these two lines, ax plus by equals k1 and cx plus dy equals k2, assuming they're not parallel lines, is this point, x equals dk1 minus bk2 over ad minus bc, and y equals negative ck1 plus ak2 over ad minus bc. This formula might look rather messy at first blush, but it actually exhibits some nice symmetries that we'll explore a bit later. For now, though, let's go ahead and code up a function to compute this intersection between two lines.